To many in the Western world, wiping one's ass after defecation is the very symbol of what makes man great. When a mess is made, we clean it up. The substance used to wipe the ass is known as toilet paper, commonly sold, widely available. There was, however, a time not so long ago when the simple roll of soft tissue was in high demand. So much so that it sold out across the entire country.
It was a war zone out there.
I'd never seen anything like it. People went crazy.
Some say that our true animal instincts came out that week.
I'm still haunted by it. I think it was nothing but a great example of how far man is willing to go to have a clean asshole.
My friends outside Australia would always ask, why toilet paper? To which I could only reply, I have no idea.
February 2020.
And we do want to get right to our top story.
The world was in panic mode over the coronavirus.
In the coronavirus outbreak, as the number of cases and deaths.
The reaction was mostly universal.
The government has again tightened Australia's borders.
But one country had an unusual side effect to the worldwide panic.
Will not be allowed into Australia for.
Corona was affecting a lot of things, but no one expected what was about to happen.
Monday, the 2nd of March 2020. The first Australian died from the coronavirus.
We've recorded the first death from the disease since its outbreak.
Causing the media to go into a frenzy.
The first death we've had from coronavirus in Australia.
People just got worried. Now that an Australian had died, it was apparently time to start stocking up.
Many in the general public start stockpiling household items in fear of the virus spreading to their town.
We went out to take a look for ourselves yesterday and there wasn't a toilet roll in sight.
The first item to sell out was toilet paper.
Yeah, it was quite the sight. Toilet paper aisle is never empty.
The toilet paper aisle is never empty. Everyone started taking photos.
It didn't take long for the photos to spread. Social media fueled the fire, with the news media following.
You almost have to go out and stock up now, because if you don't, when you actually need it, you're down to like one or two rolls.
Everyone started thinking, well, if they're doing it, I'm doing it.
Not everybody was doomsday prepping, but everybody was kind of thinking, what am I going to wipe my ass with? So.
The stockpiling snowballed.
Suddenly, it wasn't a joke anymore.
Aisles all over the country, empty.
Retail staff found themselves in uncharted territory.
We'd confuse old people asking where the toilet paper was.
Unable to give customers an explanation.
Some were pleading. They had none left and a whole family to care for.
A whole family of asses.
Friday, March 7th, the crisis reaches boiling point.
It was crazy out there. People were scrapping.
Fighting in the aisles. It was madness.
Suddenly, this necessity was no longer available. When something that is required is no longer readily available, things turn ugly.
In response to the chaos, supermarket chain Woolworths issues a statement announcing a two-pack per transaction limit on toilet paper.
The limit was a good idea, but it came too late.
To manufacturers, they were trying to keep up, but there were still so many families that had nothing to wipe their asses with.
Phones were ringing off the hook. We were getting abused on a minute-by-minute basis. It was hell.
They don't prepare you for what we had to go through, because it was unprecedented.
There wasn't an instruction manual for this.
Generals in command spent hours in crisis talks. Meetings went into the night.
What do you do when you've got hundreds of people all needing to take a dump with nothing to wipe their butts with?
Texts and Facebook messages were sent from those on the front line.
My dearest Jane, the battle for TP wages on. I've started cleaning the holes in the walls so that I can once again feel the lost luxury of wiping a crack. Scott Kelly, Meet Cold Room.
Dearest mother, I'm trying to see the positive side to this pandemic. The only thing I can come up with is my awe of dogs. They don't need toilet paper, they just push out their crap and go about their day. Humans should be more like dogs. Ben Chambers, Produce Prep Area.
My darling Emily, the faint memory of your soft hands keep me fighting. The front line of this battlefield is harsh and dry, much like the printer paper I've been forced to use on my butt. Tina Hewick, checkout number 4.
Blake, it's ironic, but I'm shitting myself that someone's going to find out we've been stockpiling toilet paper since last week. Please, make sure you keep the pile hidden and the doors locked. Remember, sweetheart, we live in Coomera. Lauren Sullivan, Cleaner's Closet.
It was a war zone out there, but we found solace out the back. Reflecting on the good old days when we had shit paper to sell.
It was nice to forget for a while what was going on out there.
People were even doing dodgy deals out the back.
We thought it would be over within a day or two, but we were wrong.
It's funny that during the worst times of humanity, you tend to see the best in humanity.
Tuesday, March 10th, an emergency load of toilet paper arrives in stores across the country.
It was a great day. Seeing those rolls come off the truck, I'll never forget it.
Days later, reports come in from all over of shelves once again brimming with life.
Because of all the extra pallets that were coming and the buying limit, the shelves, they came back to life. And it was the first sign that the end of times, that terrible time, you know, it was over.
So too did reports of celebrations.
I hadn't been happier in my life. Just knowing that folks out there were finally wiping their asses, it was a nice thought. Hindsight is a wonderful thing. A great lesson was to be learnt from this, that you don't know what you've got until it's gone.
I don't think any of us will ever take wiping our butthole for granted ever again.
We suffered so that our kids and our grandkids have the freedom to wipe their asses. That means something.
After the crisis, Australians come together. People who stockpiled donated generously to those who didn't fare so well during the shortage. The country slowly got back on its feet, wiped its ass, and got on with it. But even though it's back to business as usual, Australia will never forget the one time it was really hard to get toilet paper.